And we're back on primetime on ANC. Now, while most voters complained of long lines, the heat, and complications with the use of the PCOS machines, imagine just how much harder it was for the elderly and persons with disabilities. Some of them forced their way through 3 to 4 flights of stairs just to be able to vote. The National Council on Disability Affairs, or the NCDA, slams COMELEC for supposedly failing to promote the rights of PWDs to suffrage. The group says out of over 36,000 polling centers in the midterm polls, there are only two accessible polling places designated for PWDs.
Oh, that's right, Tony. That's two special polling centers in Cavite, supposed to service over 362,000 registered voters with disabilities all over the country. The NCDA calls the situation a, quote, slap on the dignity of voters with disabilities. The group says they were not even consulted on that matter, Tony.
Now, for our discussion, we're joined here in the studio by COMELEC Commissioner Grace Padaca, Director Esmeralda Ladra, the Vice Chair of the COMELEC Committee on PWD Voting, and Carmen Zubiaga, the Executive Director of the National Council on Disability Affairs.
You can, of course, join our discussion tonight by sending us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag Primetime, or post them on our Facebook page. That's ANC247. Ladies, good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. Commissioner, good evening and thanks for joining us.
Hi.
Tony.
Thank you. So, I guess idea of assisting PWDs to vote hasn't really caught on that much, has it? Given that your experience is there weren't a lot of these polling centers that had any kind of provision for PWDs at all.
But Tony, in our preparations for making things more accessible to persons with disability, we're not only talking about accessible polling places, mm-hmm. the ones that we set up in Las Marinas, Cavite,
yeah.
but also giving them priority through the express lanes in each precinct, and making efforts also to bring down precincts where there are identified persons with disability to the ground floor. I emphasize the word identify because our election officers, as well as the school officials, had to know if a certain precinct had registered PWD voters. Mm-hmm. Kailangan po kasing naka-emphasize yun because, for example, I am a PWD myself, but I have been registered for quite some time.
Okay.
There were no registration forms yet during my time that specified or identified me as a person with disability. Mm. It was only during the special registrations in 2011 and 2012 that there were registration forms specifying that the voter is a person with disability, what disability he or she has, and what kind of assistance will he need on election day.
So, dapat commissioner may separate list talaga yon sa polling precinct.
Yes, that's why there were some complaints about people with mobility problems, people on wheelchairs, needing to vote, needing to go up the stairs to the third or fourth floor. But we believe that they were the ones who did not update their registration in 2011 and 2012.
Okay, but let me talk to Ms. Zubiaga now. Wouldn't it be easier for the COMELEC to just assume that for every polling center that there will be at least one person with disability that will vote on that day, and we shouldn't wait for these people to update their statuses? What do you think?
Yes, actually, when I registered in 2003, mm-hmm. there is already a box which you have to tick to tell if you are a person with disability. Mm-hmm. So most likely, since 2003, it has been it should have been identified that there are persons with disabilities in every precinct, mm-hmm. and prior to the 2013 election, we formed an interagency committee preparing for persons with disabilities to vote and encourage them to exercise their rights to suffrage. Mm-hmm. And our call was supported by a lot of volunteer groups, international organization, until such time that COMELEC came up with a resolution and bank allowing to establish a polling precinct for every person with disability. And we discussed for 3 years. We had campaign. There is the Fully Abled Nation campaign supported by international NGOs and overseas aids. Mm-hmm. And we have mobilized so many people around the nation, and we really go into different cities just to campaign for persons with disabilities to register and vote, which is also one of the reasons why the record of voters with disabilities increased from increased to about 65,000. It has reached about 380,000 voters. So, and 2 weeks before the election, there was this resolution identifying a pilot polling precinct, and there was confusion around. And in fact, I have been calling, I have received so many calls and texts from the volunteer organizations and the funders of the empowering PWDs to vote, and they were all really very irritated about that resolution identifying two polling places. And then, I don't know about that. So I called the office of Commissioner Padaca, and she assured me that it's only in Dasmariñas, because Dasmariñas requested that they establish two polling places because they identified 187 persons with disabilities in those two precincts. So they made a resolution allowing those precincts to have support staff. So that's what I explained to those people, and we really do not want to add to confusion. So we did not made any statement regarding that, because we want to be kept quiet and we don't want to add to the confusion. And that's why during my during our interview in before the election in one of the TV shows, we really assured that everyone can vote. And we were very confident that it was included in the orientation of all the election officers, but we were receiving different feedback, because the election officers do not want anymore to move to establish those polling precincts because of the confusion in that in that resolution. Mm-hmm. So we just when we were interviewed again, I just spread out the, just text me, or if you encountered any problem, let me talk to your election officer. So that's what we did. We just, but they really encountered so much problem, and that resulted to that most, like in one area in Valenzuela, about 25 persons on wheelchairs were there, and they were carried one by one.
So nakaboto pa rin sila, but with much difficulty.
And they called me, because the election officers didn't want to bring the ballots downstairs. But I talked to her, and she agreed to bring it down. And that was already 3 o'clock in the afternoon. When I talked to the election officer, that is the only time that most of the people in the wheelchair were able to vote.
Okay, let's hear from Director Ladra from the COMELEC Law Department. So the resolution passed was actually to identify which polling precinct in Cavite would be given special provisions for PWDs.
Yes, that's correct. No, but first, before I answer the question and elaborate on it, I just would like to point out also that PWDs are persons with disabilities. Marami po yung klase. It's not only a problem on visual, on hearing. Mm-hmm. We have also mobility. Yung sa speech, mobility especially, or the physical problem. We have even identified them as yung may multiple disabilities, and even yung manifest, non-manifest.
Okay.
So in considering all those, actually we have been collaborating, of course, with the member ho kasi ng maraming organizations ang member natin sa Interagency on the Empowerment of PWDs. And we have done it during the time we have created that group during the time of Commissioner Sarmiento. No?
Okay.
And in fairness also to Commissioner Grace Padaca, when Commissioner Sarmiento retired in February, the first 2 days in February, she came in. So, na-organize na namin yung ating inter-agency. And of course, Madam Carmen was one of the members, and we of course appreciated also the efforts, the joint efforts of everyone, not only in NCDA but other agencies of the government, like especially the Commission on Human Rights, the DOJ, the PWH. Marami po kaming involved on.
Okay.
And so we've been planning for the PWDs to have an accessible polling place. And in fact, the resolution was passed way back 2012. July. That was April or July.
July 10th.
But this resolution that she was talking about, identifying two accessible polling places in Cavite, was not 2 weeks before the election. Way back January, meron na pong report si Commissioner Sarmiento to the Honorable Commission and Bank saying that the election officers have already reported that for the PWDs, most of these clustered precincts were already placed at the ground floor of the voting centers.
Who told them that?
And from the election officers. So it was a memorandum from the Honorable Commissioner Sarmiento way back January, reporting to the Honorable Commission and Bank that reports from the field officers were telling us that they had already placed the clustered precincts with PWDs at the ground floor. Mm-hmm. And in fact, even before that, there was already a resolution, and during the time of Commissioner Chairman Melo, mm-hmm. there was already a resolution to cater to the PWDs, senior citizens, and the
Do you feel now that you actually got inaccurate reports or feedback from your field officers?
Actually, we, of course, sino namang pagkatiwalaan namin, ano? Maybe they have not really put everyone or all the precincts who have, which have PWD voters at the ground floor, kasi syempre, especially in cities, no, baka marami yan sila nagka-iwahiwalay in several clustered precincts. So baka hindi lahat mailagay sa ground floor, but they were saying most of those clustered precincts with PWD voters were already placed downstairs. Pero only Cavite election officer was asking or requesting for an accessible polling place. That's why in the report of Commissioner Sarmiento, he was already able to identify the two areas in Cavite. And that resolution also, when Commissioner Padaca came in, was actually a follow-through of that identification of these two polling precincts in Cavite.
Uh-huh.
I think we should define what an accessible polling place is. Not every precinct can be an accessible polling place. Kasi po ang ibig sabihin ng accessible polling place, sa isang eskwela kung saan may limang presinto halimbawa, each of these precincts have PWD voters there, then the sixth one, an accessible polling place, could be established so that the ballots of these PWDs who are in the different polling places, precincts, will be brought to this special accessible polling place. Mm. So that they will all go that there. We will make special provisions for PWDs, fix the comfort rooms, make the tiles PWD friendly. And at the end of the voting hours, all their ballots will be brought back to each of the precincts. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But we can't do that, Carmina and Tony, for all the 80,000
clustered precincts.
Why?
Yes,
why
because
not?
that will require that will require special places, special training for Board of Election Inspectors, and many of the reported precincts have like 25. For example, in Valenzuela, if Carmen says it's 25, if we do that for all precincts with 25 PWDs, then we may as well do it for the rest of the country. So we had the ones where we established accessible polling places had 183 and 187. Yung pong yung ganun na siya kalaki.
Yeah, but you're a person with disability yourself, Commissioner.
Yes.
And
I just don't, it's really baffling to me why it should be this hard. I mean, first and foremost, it's a right. Second comes the fact that there is a disability involved here. Mm-hmm. And number three, you may be fully abled now, but maybe next year, God forbid, something happens to you, and then you become a person with disability.